Today I'm going to be showing you one of Back to Health's most popular breakfast dishes with a little bit of a twist. Buckwheat pancakes are recommended to a lot of our patients, especially when they're detoxing or on a weight loss journey. That's because buckwheat is a high protein. And its name suggests that it is a wheat or a grain, but actually it's a pseudo cereal or a pseudo grain because it's harvested from the seed of the plant and not the actual grain. So you can eat buckwheat in a whole grain form, or it's also milled and hulled and milled down into a flour, which we're going to be using for the buckwheat pancakes. Now this recipe came about as a bit of a surprise, as a fluke. Buckwheat pancakes have been eaten quite often, and we usually recommend them with maple syrup. But my sister came up with this concoction of having vegetables and filling it, and it turns out to be this delicious and really easy to make savory crepe. So the whole process will take you about 15 minutes to make, and it's really good for winter when you're craving those hot breakfasts as well. So what I'm going to do first is I've got some buckwheat flour here, and I'm just going to make it for about enough for one serving. A little bit of buckwheat flour, and add to it water and mix it until it's a pancake-like consistency. Now the recipe does call for milk or water, so you can add whichever one you're more comfortable with. Some people do half milk and half water. And we want this pancake batter to be nice and smooth, with no lumps, and a little bit runny, not too thick like your regular pancake batters. So I've mixed the batter, and it's now like a runny pancake batter. This is a pretty good consistency. You can have a little bit thicker if you want it. So I've got my batter made up, and what I'm going to do is just put a spoonful or two onto the pan. And then gently spread it out till it's a nice thin crepe shape. So a good thing to do while this pancake is cooking on the pan is prep up your other vegetables that we're going to put in the pancake. Now you can add, ghee is optional to add when you're making the batter, just a few spoonfuls around when you're putting it on the pan. So pancake looks like it's about done. So all I'm going to do is carefully loosen the edges and then flip it over. Sometimes what I do, if I don't have enough time, instead of putting the pumpkin in the oven to roast, just switch on the grill, chop up your pumpkin in small pieces, coat it in some olive oil, stick it in the grill, and it'll cook super fast there. And then all we're going to do with our spinach, so I'll show you in a second, is you get normal spinach or baby spinach, wash it, dry it, and then just put it on your pancake pan for about 2 minutes, and you'll see it wilt and cook, and it's ready to add to the pancake. The pancake's just about cooked. I flipped it over onto the other side, and I'll take it onto the plate ready for serving. You just have to mix it around for about a minute, and then they'll be cooked. So we've got the pancake ready. All we do is add some cooked and maybe chopped spinach or baby spinach, whichever one is available. Nothing hard and fast there. Then you can add pumpkin, which I've grilled earlier and it's cooked, a few pieces, and some avocado, which I've also chopped up and prepared earlier. Season with a bit of salt and pepper. And there you have it, a gourmet style pancake that's ready in 15 minutes. So there you have it, a quick, easy, and super fast breakfast that's made in 15 minutes, plus it's extremely delicious. And you can even change up the vegetables inside to suit whatever's in your fridge. For example, another good combination inside is sweet potato, beans, and kale leaves, or even you could do asparagus steamed with some grilled zucchini and kale or baby spinach. So really be creative, use whatever's in your fridge, and try new things. Thank you.